good. How you doing?
Good. How's Vegas treating you? How long have you been here for?
Oh, looks great.
Like an hour.
Just an hour? You just touched down?
Yeah.
Where'd you come from?
Los Angeles.
Okay. Not too bad. Not too far away.
Yeah, but Vegas is good in general. I've been here before.
Yeah. What are you looking forward to this trip around? Besides your performance, is there anything you're looking forward to doing? Any trouble you're looking forward to getting into?
I don't know if I want to admit it on camera, but I don't know. Just I might hit the slots. I might get a little sippy.
How much money are you looking to lose this weekend?
I don't know. One time I played in Vegas and I put $20 in and made $200,
and
didn't make shit else after that.
So. Wow. Wait, so you blew the $200?
Yeah, they were watching me for sure. Damn. They were like, let's get them good and started, and then all downhill from there. So
that's rough. That is rough.
Yeah.
So I know you've been doing a lot of, let's walk through these aisles first and foremost, because we're in the dollar records section, the bargain bin section. We can kind of thumb through them, pull out anything that you see that might interest you. I know you've been really, really busy lately. Talk to me a little bit about how you are preparing for this performance that you're doing in just a few hours.
I prepare for all performances the same, really. Mm-hmm. You know, I just kind of get a little bit of silence beforehand, a little bit to myself, and then I just de-stress throughout the entire day. But that's my plan, but that usually never happens. I'm usually stressed about something.
What is
You know, that's just how I live. I like to be stressed. This guy is Justin Bieber.
It kind of low-key looks like Justin Bieber before Justin Bieber. Yeah. Anne Murray, wow. Damn. Confused Justin for a whole woman. I love that. What does de-stressing look like for you? If you ideally had the time to do so, because I know you said it's kind of a fail sometimes.
De-stressing for me is doing anything not music industry related.
Because
all that shit's stressful as hell.
Yeah.
So de-stressing for me, it just looks like me being a regular person, honestly.
Okay.
And that's like, it's weird that I have to make time to do that, but it is what it is.
Yeah, it's almost about like being intentional, I guess, about that. So your sound is very interesting, very unique. You're very unafraid with your lyrics. Can you kind of talk to me about how you got to that point where you're just kind of like, I created this lane for myself. I've always been myself, and I'm gonna say what I want to say.
Failure and like doubt, I guess. People just doubt you a lot, and eventually you just kind of build up a defense mechanism about your own self,
okay,
and your own self-image, in your art, and you just become so confident in it because it's just like it's you know.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And I get more incentivized because like a lot of people told me there was no way in hell I'd ever make a dime from the shit I was making. So obviously they didn't know what the hell they were talking about.
Clearly.
But like that's basically it. So.
Yeah, I feel like the transition you made was pretty big, going from the military to doing music, which I feel like it's something that's very like strict and there's a plan, all of that stuff, to music where it's kind of like up in the air and like there's more freedom.
I've always been the type that's like the up in the air stuff, you know. I just had to do the military because I was just poor.
Fair enough.
This guy looks like this album
in distress.
Shit's gonna give you a headache.
He said it's nothing but a breeze though.
He said nothing but a breeze.
He looks stressed.
He's just like, fuck.
I want to know a little bit more about Offline.
Tell us a
bit more about how that came together.
That is just a compilation of songs that were left off album I released last year called LP.
Mm-hmm.
I just, once I got off my label, I was able to put it out myself. So
yeah.
I just put it out just as a little EP. And those aren't really new songs. They're just like songs that were attached to the original record but couldn't get released at the time.
Right. Okay, so it's funny because that coming out surprised a lot of people because
it's white.
It's very white.
It's the whole shit.
What's on the back?
Oh. More white.
Yep.
Just more white activity.
So it surprised me when you dropped that. I mean, obviously, like you said, it was like things that you couldn't put on LP.
Yeah.
But I know that you had said online that you were going to kind of take a little bit of a break that may or may not have been permanent. Where are you at in regards to that? And in regards to overcoming burnout, if you've overcome it?
I haven't really overcome burnout.
Okay.
You know? I just kind of like get comfortable working a lot because it's just what I like to do.
Yeah.
I've just burned out of releasing things because, like, you know, releasing an album with songs that aren't on it, that mm-hmm. you want to be on it, is not really releasing what you want to do, you know?
Right.
So, I just needed a break because like I'd spent so many years making things to meet deadlines and like editing things because like somebody's scared someone's gonna sue me or something. I just needed to be away from that energy. So I'm way far from that energy now.
Gotcha.
I'm good. I'm chilling.
What does your creative process look like these days with that freedom now? And how do you create? Are you creating on the go? Are you? What does that look like for you?
You just create when you get the chance. You know, whenever you if you're touring a lot and you're really busy, you don't really have time to create and sit down at home in a studio, go to a studio like regular people. You kind of have to do it when you can.
Right.
And that's basically it. I just I figure it out, as they say.
Gotcha. Do you wish you had that time? Can we take a look at this? What is happening here? Like, I almost feel like this is very invasive. Like.
It's like he's watching someone. He's watching his wife cheat on him.
Right, exactly. It's very strange.
But you said what now?
What? I don't know what the hell I just said. Yeah, oh, I said, do you wish that you had that opportunity to just like kind of be at home creating in a home studio or just in one place, space?
That's the best. That's the ideal situation. Mm-hmm. But you know, if I was at home creating all the time, I wouldn't be out doing things, and you know, I don't know. It's like a trade-off almost. Cause like, I would ideally like to, because it'd give me the time and freedom, but I feel like I have to earn that time, you know?
Right.
Otherwise, like, I don't know, you can fizzle out, you can stop being hot.
No, for
anything can happen when you're trying to take time off, so it's just like, you gotta earn it, you know? You gotta, like, Kanye can take time off whenever, you know? Cause he's do whatever he wants. But like, yeah, I'd like to earn that kind of time.
Yeah.
That's how I feel about it. You gotta earn that time.
Gotcha. Okay, so obviously we're in a record store right now. Were there any vinyls that you listened to coming up through your parents or just in general?
What, some vinyls?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I started listening to like Marvin Gaye through my dad's vinyls.
Love that.
Like What's Going On and stuff like that.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think of what else was on vinyl. Just a lot of old reggae stuff.
Ah.
Like, yeah, my parents' vinyl collection is like old dance all stuff and like soul records.
Yeah.
And that's my dad. My mom doesn't have any. She doesn't. I don't even know if she listens to music, to be honest.
Really?
Yeah.
Wait, does she listen to your music though?
Hell no.
Wait, seriously?
Yeah, no.
Okay, do you have an issue with that? Like, have you tried to force it down her throat at all?
Nah.
No?
Okay.
What are your thoughts on her not listening to your music though?
I don't really have any thought. I don't really care. It's what she's supposed to do, not like it, you know?
That's
really
fair.
It doesn't really matter to me.
That's fair.
I guess I never really respect her opinion on music to begin with. So
oh, so then it really
I just
doesn't
don't
matter.
Really care. It's like, whatever.
Okay, but if there were three of your songs that you wanted her to listen to, maybe to get to know you better, because sometimes I feel like parents, as adults, like, they have to relearn who we are. So if there were three of your songs that you wanted her to listen to get to know you better, what would they be?
I don't know. Bald 1539 and Jesus Forgive Me, I Am a Thought. I think she would like that one.
Ah, I love it.
I think she would like that one a lot.
I love that. I love that so much. Okay, should we keep walking?
Yeah, for sure.
Let's see what's down here. There's some
soundtracks.
What's
in the comedy?
Actually, yeah, let's see what's in
the
comedy.
No one ever looks in the comedy.
Nobody ever looks in the comedy, that part.
What's in the comedy?
Anything good? That I like that art on this one. What's this?
Which one?
Let's see.
This looks like a sitcom from like today.
It does. It does. I wouldn't watch it, but
it's like an SNL sketch.
Right. What do you think about this? There's a lot going on.
Probably some crazy shit on here. I don't know what is this.
As far as your art and your visuals go, do you play? Do you have a major hand in that, in creating that stuff?
In my art and visual, yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. I have a huge hand in it. You know, not as much as the actual music, but. Mm-hmm. Definitely a whole bunch.
Yeah,
sure.
Yeah. Let's go this way.
Which one?
This way. We're going down. What holiday? Should we look through the holiday bin? Let's look through the holiday. No, you look like nah. We shouldn't.
I mean, there ain't no Mariah Carey in there already.
You know what?
We know what we're doing.
Listen, there should be. She's iconic. Yeah. I feel like I may have pulled that out though the other day when we were looking through our stuff.
It is bulletproof vinyl. Damn.
It really is.
Thick ass vinyl.
Right. For those people who might be just kind of stumbling upon the stage that you'll be performing at this weekend, what do you hope they learn about you as an artist?
I don't really know if I hope they learn anything, you know. I just hope they walk by and enjoy it if they don't know me.
Yeah.
Hopefully they enjoy it and listen to it in their private, in the privacy of their own home.
Mm-hmm.
I don't really think I walk up there and I'm just like, I really hope people who
don't know me think this about me, because it's just like, it's impossible to like control that, you know.
That's real.
It's just kind of like whatever. I've been performing. I know who I am.
Right.
I don't need like that outside. I don't need any new outside validation. At least I'm not seeking it. Like,
yeah.
If it comes to me, that's great. But I'm not like trying to like market myself to like new people.
For
just,
sure.
Like whatever, man. I don't give a fuck.
For sure. I feel like that's the best way to create.
Also, like, why is this a genre?
What, album covers? I mean, people buy vinyls for the covers sometimes.
Well, what if, no? What if it don't sound good? Like, that's weird. It's weird.
Let's
to have
see. Is there one that catches your eye in that mix?
These?
They're all a dollar. If you came in with $5, which five are you pulling out of this album covers?
Five?
Crate.
I mean, it could be, look at all this crazy shit. You can literally just...
Lionel Richie. I mean, come on.
And in the middle of that, Lionel Richie just sitting his light-skinned ass down right in the middle of all this chaos.
So you're pulling Lionel Richie with your first dollar.
Yeah, look at that.
Okay.
Look at that 80s hair.
Who else?
Whatever the hell this is.
Okay.
Yeah, all this shit is hella strange. This. Okay. And this classical dude who looks like he smoked.
I love it.
Jesus, girl, what's going on here?
She got a lot going on. Listen, when people consider you or call you the voice of Gen Z, does that feel like a burden at all?
Fuck. No, I don't know who calls me that.
Is that a compliment or an insult for you?
It's a misnomer. I'm 32 years old. Not the voice of no damn Jay Z.
I love that so much. Let's keep looking.
I have this record. Our...
Do you?
Yeah, I have this record.
Wait, Judy, who
Collins.
Is that?
Judy Collins.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
It's called Judas. It's good. It's a good record.
Gotcha. It looks like it clearly wasn't one that you bought for the cover, though, because that cover was given basic.
I actually bought it for the cover because...
Did you?
Yeah, because that's what the good shit is, when it's just someone just like...
Okay. Like, there's mystery there, I guess.
Let's put some work into this because the cover ain't shit. So, yeah.
What are some of your favorite vinyls that you own? Do you own a shit ton?
Not really. I've been buying vinyls lately.
What?
What the fuck is this guy?
Show the camera.
Oh, man. Why are these so funny? I don't really know why. It's like, it's so funny, I don't even want to laugh at it. I don't really have a vinyl collection. No. I've been buying vinyls of shit of albums that I like recently, but it's literally just albums I listen to a lot.
Right.
I just buy them just to have them, because I just recently bought a vinyl player, but I don't really give a, like, I'm not really like a vinyl collector.
Okay.
You know, like that, like, I don't care about, like, collecting vinyls just for the sake of collecting them. I really just like the things that I like. If I get a good collection of things I just like, that'd be great. But yeah, I don't just walk around like just collecting shit just to collect.
Right. Okay, is there anything that you do collect that would surprise us? Do-rags. Chains.
Do-rags.
Socks. Earrings.
Actually, I do collect earrings.
Do you?
That wouldn't surprise anybody.
Yeah. Okay.
I do collect a lot of earrings. I like gather a lot. I have a lot of weird earrings that I keep locked up.
Wait, why are they locked up?
So I don't lose them.
Okay. So you just literally bought them for like the aesthetics to entertain the box that they sit in?
No, I wear them just like once.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, fair enough. Fair enough.
Just once, and then I'm good. I put them up. It's over.
Gotcha.
Let me see. Yeah.
All right. What else is catching your eye in this section?
I mean, this dog.
Oh, that's cute. He's like, I guess if that's what you call that.
I feel like nothing in this area makes sense.
I mean, it's in the bargain bin, so
for sure.
Maybe to an extent it does make sense, but it's just a dollar, right?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
I love that. Let's keep looking. Who are you listening to these days on your playlist besides yourself? Do you listen to yourself?
I mean, for pleasure.
Uh huh.
Not really.
Okay.
I don't know, new? I don't really know who I'm listening to now. I don't really know. I just listen to kind of whatever. I guess I like, what's that dude's name? I like Destroy Lonely.
Okay.
I think the kids bump him a lot. I like that whole little wave. And I like, who else do I like? There's an artist named Jane Remover I like a lot.
Okay.
Yeah, That's about it, really. I don't really give a fuck about none of the rest of these niggas. They just weird. They just weird or stupid or not good at what they do and dress interesting so people listen to them. So it's just not, I don't really care.
It's the honesty for me, and it's the boldness. I feel like you're, you stay true to yourself. You always have.
Yeah, definitely got to.
Yeah. Who holds you accountable?
What you mean?
Just in life, like, is there anybody who holds you accountable?
Holds me accountable for anything?
Yeah.
No. No. I don't have that. I don't have that at all. I have to be that for myself.
That's good. That's good.